think I want you more than want. I know I need you more than need. I wanna hold you more than hold. When you stood in front of me, I think you know me more than know. And you see me more than see. I could die now more than die. Every time you look at me. Well, I've seen you in jeans with no makeup on, and I've stood there in awe as your date for the prom. I'm blessed as a man to have seen you in white, but I've never seen anything quite like you tonight. No, I've never seen anything quite like you. When it's right, it's more than right, 'cause you feel it more than feel. I could take this moment now right into the grave with me. Oh, well, I've seen you in jeans with no makeup on, and I've stood there in awe. It's your day for the prom. I'm blessed as a man to have seen you in white, but I've never seen anything quite like you tonight. No, no, I've never seen anything quite like you tonight. Oh, no, no, I've never seen anything quite like you. Sometimes words just ain't enough for this love that's more than love. Well, I've seen you in jeans with no makeup on, and I've stood there in awe 'cause you're a date for the prom. I'm blessed as a man to have seen you in white, but I've never seen anything quite like you.
Sand on toes, cold sand in sleeping bags. I come to know that memories were the best things you ever had. The summer shorn, beat down on bony backs, so far from home where the ocean stood, down dust and pine bone tracks. slept like dogs down by the fireside. Oh, woke to the fog, we're all around us, the boom of summertime. We stood steady as the stars in the woods, so happy hearted in the warmth rang true inside these bones. As the old pine fell, we sang. Just to bless the morning. And on toes, coats and in sleeping bags, I come to know the friends around you are all you'll always have. Smoke in my lungs, or the echoed stone, careless and young, free as the birds that fly with weightless souls. We stood steady as the stars in the woods, so happy hearted in the warmth rang true inside these bones. We stood steady as the stars in the woods, so happy hearted in the warmth rang true inside these bones. As the old pine fell, we sang. Just to bless the morning.
save my life. I'm scared to death, I'm taking a chance. Blood in your inside.
took my love, took it down. I climbed a mountain and I turned around, and I saw my reflection in snow-covered hills till the landslide brought me down. Oh, mirror in the sky, what is love? Can the child within my heart rise above? Can I sail through the changing ocean tides? Can I handle the seasons of my life? Mm-hmm. Well, I've been afraid of changing, 'cause I've built my life around you. But time makes you bolder, even children get older, and I'm getting older too.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I have your attention for a moment? You're all very welcome here today for our 2020 conferring ceremony. Before the ceremony commences, and for your safety and comfort, I would like to bring the following information to your attention. There are four exits in this room, two to the left and two to the right. In the unlikely event of an emergency, we would ask you to proceed directly and calmly to the exit nearest to you. When exiting the building, please do not use the lift. Once outside the building, you'll be asked to proceed to the assembly point outside the main reception area. The assembly point is marked with green signage. In preparation for the ceremony, I would ask guests to turn off their mobile phones. If I could also ask you to please remain in your seats for the duration of the ceremony. Please be aware this event will be live streamed and photographed. If you could please stand for the graduand procession.
Thank you.
remain standing for the academic procession.
Please be seated. Ian Erica, a green Ushla file to Roy of Gideon Sharmanisha in Imran for Dov Octany or the Dakush or Rave Kemaha on Kalashtra. Distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this graduation ceremony at which third level awards will be conferred on graduates of Griffith College. I'd also like to take this opportunity to welcome graduates and their friends who are not in a position to join us here today in person and who are joining us online. Our panel members include Professor Dermot Hegarty, President of Griffith College, Councillor Sarah Keeley, Kevin O'Sullivan, Head of Griffith College Limerick, Ronan Fenlon and Kevin Gagan, Directors of Griffith College, Eamon Nolan, Head of Academic Programmes, along with the programme directors and faculty lecturers involved in the delivery of the college's programmes. I'm Dr. Tomás McGuckagon, the college's Director of Academic Programmes, and I have the pleasure of being your MC for this graduation ceremony. Contusa Carlesh de Himokti, Iramanish, Erntolav de Amitagerti, Ukhtaron Kalash de Agriafa, Lauertling, Erkiana Kalash de. I'd like to begin the proceedings by inviting Professor Dermot Hegarty, President of Griffith College, to deliver a conferring address.
Distinguished guests,
colleagues, graduands, looking very serious today. Ladies and gentlemen, from time immemorial, the Day of the Harvest has always been a day of celebration, and for you, today is that day. The day in which the seed tentatively sown by you some years ago comes to full flower. And today it's our pleasure to see you, and our privilege indeed, to see you rejoice in its flower and savour its fruit. The growth period has not always been easy. Like any plant buffeted by the storms of daily life, there were times when hands other than your own would in fact have nurtured its growth. The green fingers to which I'm referring to are those of family, partners and friends who shared your trials and tribulations, who prepared meals for you, who put up with your inevitable but hopefully few cranky moods, and those who so readily accepted the stress that you were so relieved to pass on. Including relatives who I now, I think, are calling out for an application form. I don't mean to take away from your achievements today. Today is your day, so treasure this special moment. It will live vividly in your memory for years to come. An academic award is not an entitlement of rank or class. It is won through many hours of mental toil and diligent application. No one can take this from you, so wear your gowns with pride and hold your qualifications in the high esteem they deserve. In fact, on this occasion, I'm always reminded of a story recently told by a priest at a wedding. He told the young couple I would normally tell the young couple they would come in as two people but would leave as one. And then described on a previous occasion, a previous wedding, the bride outside the church backing the unfortunate groom into a corner and telling him, "Now, John, I want you to remember from this day to the end of your life, I am the one." I think that's something that many of us in the audience could relate to. We frequently find ourselves bowing to the one. You notice I make no gender implication. But if getting married, do engage a Griffith qualified photographer in order to avoid the and protect against the mishap of a couple whose photographs were taken outside the church. And afterwards they admired the photographs of the happy bride and groom, bride with her family, the groom with his family, and all their friends and relations. But they noticed one common backdrop to all of the photographs, which was the sermon of Easter week. On a big notice board outside the church were the words, "Forgive them, Lord, they know not what they do." I feel I can be reasonably safe in recounting that story to this group, because this is a group that clearly knows where it is going and what it is doing. And well done for that. As president of the college, you'd wish me to acknowledge the work of my colleagues who contributed to your success, that is, as members of boards, as lecturers, as administrators, librarians, and faculty members. I'm delighted to welcome our distinguished guest, Councillor Sarah Kiley, Fine Gael. And Sarah was elected in May 2019 to represent Limerick City East and covers the area east, the area from Hyde Road to Castleconnan. She was elected Cathaoirleach of the Metropolitan District of Limerick 1 year later in 2020. On a personal basis, I would like to share some personal reflections with you relating to the future. And I do so because, to my mind, that future lies in the hands of you and your children. Since the last graduation ceremony, our family had the joy of three grandchildren, with one more due by the end of this year. As my wife says, it's like the buses. You wait for one and they all come together. But these three matters of concern for their future occurred to me, and occurred that I should share them with you, because, as I said, it is your generation that will deal with them. And they are world peace, global climate, and world health. All of us are obviously concerned with the impact of the conflict in Ukraine on world peace. We fervently wish for peace, not only for the Ukrainians, but also for the young Russian conscripts. Peace at what price? And how? History has shown us it cannot be one-sided. We've learnt that in here in Northern Ireland. In all conflicts, the point is reached, eventually, where conciliation is conceivable to both sides. And we've seen this in Northern Ireland. The time may not be now, but it will come. That's for certain. And at that point, the value of a peacemaking approach, which brings both sides to conciliation using an element of fudge, is critical. And I mention fudge because it is fudge that, in fact, basically eliminates or smooths out the sharp edges. She tries to show, if you like, by, to a certain extent, restating the issues, tries to show that there is some commonality, there is a way forward between the parties. And I think that it is it's a very valuable art. It's an art of fudge, in fact, is one that has been served us very well in Northern Ireland, where we found a form of wording that meant different things to both sides, and yet acknowledge each of their situations. And that, in fact, is a very important art when it actually comes, a very important art of diplomacy when it comes to peacemaking. And it just seems to me that the art of fudge is well described in these words. When we are lawyer-like and young, there are just colours too. Then black describes what must be done, and red what not to do. So long we take to pigments mix, see brown, but just a smudge. intractables we fail to fix, no, not the art of fudge. When men would die were black deeds done, and red with blood would rivers run, could only the insane begrudge the blessed saving art of fudge. The vast majority of us would say, look, the issues are black and white, it's quite clear. Yet valuing human life as we should do, and hoping there are some decent people who can influence the outcome, we might consider the lesson learnt by an old man one morning. Following a big storm, he found his beach littered with tens of thousands of starfish. He noticed a small boy throwing the starfish into the ocean. Asking why, the boy replied, the tide has washed them up. They can't return themselves, and they will perish in the sun unless I throw them back. And the old man replies, but there must be tens of thousands of starfish on the beach. Can you really make a difference? And the boy, picking up another starfish and throwing it far into the ocean, turned, smiled, and said, it made a difference to that one. So let us pray for this difference to human life as soon as possible, to as many lives as possible in Ukraine. And one might consider the precedent set in mainland Europe, which was locked in 1944 in a bitterly destructive war driven by a despot. These European countries, 7 years later, signed the European Coal and Steel Community Treaty, representing the first step towards European integration. And let us hope that peace will bring hope and trade, where Ukraine could benefit from being a bridge between European and Russian economies. Look at the history of Europe and look at the situation in 1944, compare it with now, where a war between those countries, in fact, would be regarded as utterly unthinkable because of the relations that were built through trade and economics between the countries. So there is a future, there always is a future. And this year, we've witnessed loss of life due to forest fires and flash floods. I move on to the climate effect. We are warned that these are the first effects of planet overheating. Indeed, most recently, we've been told that the world's glaciers will have fully melted by 2050. Clearly, we need to recognize the impact of our lifestyle on the planet gifted to us. We are just birds of passage and must pass this gift to future generations as we find it. Of this, we need to constantly remind ourselves, and I suggest these words might represent an appropriate reminder. Remind us, Lord, as we sit down to eat, of fishes, loaves, and water turned to wine. These miracles that you each day repeat as sun and earth give life to your design. Oh, how we take for granted precious air and miracles like photosynthesis. Our carbon footprint stains the heavens stare while we have yet to learn to leave as is. Remind us, Lord, how short the span of life. Our pleasures, like ourselves, are sure to die, and they would not beget our children's strife if we just cherish water, earth, and sky. World health is still an issue of concern. One thing this global pandemic has taught us is resilience in the face of severe adversity. It demonstrates to us that we had no other choice but to embrace radical change, and that by facing the challenges head on and adapting to our ever-changing circumstances, that we could prevail. The pandemic forced us to embrace the dawning of the era of agility. We are not yet rid of COVID. We must maintain vigilance and agility learned throughout the pandemic to face any future threats. The college business faculty has grown from strength to strength, partly due to a network of collaborations with business schools across the globe, from Paris and Munich to Beijing and Shanghai. Due to the high relevance of course content to current needs of employers, following a recent programmatic review, our business graduates are now fully employable. Graduates of the Diploma in International Hospitality are sought after for their mixture of practical and theoretical knowledge and have gone on to work in world-renowned hotels, including Limerick's own Adair Manor. This is our first group of graduates from the Digital Sales Technology Programme. We're delighted that the programme received springboard funding again this year. The Higher National Certificate in Manufacturing Industry for which we students receive awards today, was offered in Limerick only. It will be used to gain entry into the Industrial and Systems Engineering Group. It's a two-year course, provides for basic grounding in manufacturing engineering skills at QQI Level 6. Manufacturing engineering provides the skills to problem-solve engineering issues and processes, to identify methods of eliminating quality defects in products produced. Our engineering graduates benefit from our collaboration with the Institute of Industrial and System Engineers, and they will bring about continuous change in the workplace and thus avoid the trauma of ultimately dealing with years of neglected change. Industrial engineers optimize complex processes, systems, and organizations. They work to eliminate the waste of time, money, materials, man-hours, machine time, energy, and other resources. As Ireland's economy continues to grow apace, our graduate skills have never been more invaluable. This is a truly international group. In fact, in Tumor Park, I think I'm almost at an international match. I wish to congratulate them, our international students, and welcome them in their own language. I would urge any of you who wish to function successfully in this international economy, this commercial world of the 21st century, to visit China and indeed learn Chinese, and in their language, may I say, Jinjian, Woman Fei Chong Gao Xing, Chindala, Woman Zhongo Shu Sheng De Jia Jiang He Qing Gao. Jinjian, Wo Sheng Niman De Fu Mu He Peng Yao Shuo. Niman Zai Ireland Shu Shi Fei Chong Lu Li. Yin Wei Yo Niman, Zhongo De Wei Lai Ar Gong Jia Mei Li. Now, I've just welcomed the Chinese students, families, and friends, and stated their hard work bodes well for their future and the future of China. Estudantes brasileiros y portugueses, parabéns. Ecoses familiares y amigos, sean bienvenidos. Mapiba de Naja, how far, how your day? Congratulations for you study Nowahala. Now that you're part of the Griffith alumni, don't hesitate to set your sights on the pinnacle of your profession. Your standards are set by your fellow alumni, who over the past few years took 34 prizes, and so far this year have taken again 19 prizes across all accounting body examinations. These include a first in the world in ACCA, three first in Ireland and ACA places, among 542,000 students in 181 countries worldwide, together with 14 first places in the CPA examinations in Ireland. We all have a natural tendency to leave things and to leave the difficult to last, forgetting that the more readily we negotiate the thorns, the closer we smell the roses. The Maori proverb puts it well: turn your face to the sun and the shadows fall behind you. Remember, the sun will rise and fall regardless. What you do with the light is up to you. Some of you may even feel this is beyond your control. The future is beyond your control. I propose to you Abraham Lincoln's opposite viewpoint. The best way to predict your future is to create it. Sooner you embrace that journey, the better, because on that journey, time flies, but you are the pilot. And have no doubt, great challenges await you, particularly to do things you've never done before. Just remember, the expert in anything was once a beginner. You're going to fall. Don't worry how many times. Just make sure it's one less than the number of times you get back up. Remember, you're always a student. Not like the school child responding after the first day at school. When asked by his mother, "What did you learn today?" He said, "Obviously not enough. They want me back again tomorrow." So just as we seek to rely on you for our future, so we must pledge in return a future for Griffith College in which you will be proud to call yourselves a Griffith graduate. Key to the value of your award will be university status for Griffith College. And the college programmes are already accredited by Quality and Qualifications Ireland, QQI, and internationally benchmarked through our National Qualifications Framework. QQI has devolved to Griffith College to responsibility for the operation of programme validation. The next stage is delegation of authority delegation of authority to make awards, under which the awards that you will see would be Griffith College Awards, and they will be issued to you under the authority of the Irish state. And we hope in time to follow the technological universities into university status, and that would seem only right, as many of the institutions, many of these technological universities are smaller in size and established for a shorter period than Griffith College. Nothing is achieved without stress or strain. And when you get to my age, you greatly value diminishing memory capacity. I recall the memory difficulties of a colleague who sat in a restaurant with his wife, trying to recall the name of a restaurant in which he'd eaten the previous week. He called over the waitress and he asked her, "Tell me the name of a flower." And she said, "Rose." He said, "No." She said, "Tulip." He said, "No." And then she said, "Lily." And he said, "Ah, yes." And he turned to his wife and said, "Lily, what was the name of the restaurant in which we ate last week?" So hopefully from that you will appreciate the stresses and strains undergone by lecturers and students at exam time. To all the graduates, may I express the hope that over your period with us, Griffith College will have found a place in your hearts that you have in ours. I want you to know that you're always welcome on campus, socially or educationally, or just to show off the new BMW. Reverting to the theme of the harvest where I started, the words of the author James Allen so well describe the joint roles of college and student in your development. The law of the harvest is reap more than you sow. Sow an act and you reap a habit. Sow a habit and you reap a character. Sow a character and you reap a destiny. May I conclude by congratulating you again on your success and by wishing you may harness the knowledge and experience acquired in Griffith College to achieve what you richly deserve, a successful and fulfilling career. In the words of the song of Wandering Angus of W.B. Yeats, may you pluck till time and times are done, the silver apples of the moon and golden apples of the sun. Thank you.
Anish, Iribarren Corlor, Sarah Kiley, Lauert Leonard Rave Kemaha. I would now like to invite Councillor Sarah Kiley to address the graduands.
President, distinguished guests, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for the invitation to share your monumental day. When I was asked to attend, I was a little taken aback and surprised. I was even more surprised when I was asked to address you. As someone who came to third level education late in life, I must acknowledge the work and commitment you have given to arrive at this point today. No doubt it wasn't an easy road, and given the pandemic and how teaching and learning was massively effective, you showed resilience and adaptability. You chose to invest in yourselves, and thankfully this has paid off. This is most definitely the beginning of an exciting chapter in your life. I'm not an academic, and as I said, I came late to third level education, but my message to you today is be brave. Grab any opportunity presented to you with both hands. Take a risk. Life is short. Be proud of your accomplishments. Limerick has always been my home. What are Limerick's biggest assets? I believe it is you, and I believe it is the people of Limerick. When you choose to study here, you became ours and us yours. You live and work here. You are now part of Limerick. And even if you leave, I hope a piece of her stays always in your heart. Griffith College has built links with local industry. It has been here for 16 years. I hope you've enjoyed your time in Limerick, if you are a visitor to Limerick, and if you are a resident, I hope you stay. On behalf of the city, Thank you for being here, for adding to the fabric of who we are. I was invited here pre-pandemic, and I reminded people when we were in the holding area out the back that it was 3 years ago, pre-pandemic. That day inspired me. I decided to go back to education at that point because of people like you, people of all age, people of all backgrounds. So next week I'll be in your shoes and I will be graduating from UCC. So thank you, all of you, for that. You can inspire people to achieve. You can be an ambassador for education, for perseverance and for Limerick. Do not underestimate the influence and power you hold. Congratulations, enjoy the occasion, and again, well done.
Anish, boil and fight to arrive the in Kitcho the Nokide in a run for a colleague the Nashunta, August Ider Nashunta, a rave came on Kalashta. I now welcome you to the part of our proceedings at which national and international awards will be conferred on graduates of the college, and I declare open this awards ceremony. Irmanish are in Tullive Dermot Tegarty, Uchtharon Kalash de Grefa, Colliach de Narshunta, Agus Idr Narshunta Vrunna, Erna Rave Kemaha, Athother Herbert Egan Galashta. I call upon Professor Dermot Tegarty, President of Griffith College, to confer awards on the graduates of the college presented by the college for that purpose.
Can I first, if I may, explain the significance of this point in the ceremony, and what effectively we are doing now is carrying out the act of conferring awards. So far, what in fact we have, you would say to me, well, we've actually done everything that is required of us to actually become graduates. And you will notice that, in fact, in the course of my discourse, I refer to you as graduands, and those are in course of graduation, not as graduates, okay? And it's that point of conferring at which your award's upon you that you become graduates, okay? It's a formal act of conferring. And you would say to me, well, we've passed the exams, we have tens of the lectures, we've submitted our assignments, and they've been successfully marked. We are surely already there. But it actually that point of conferring of your awards, that formal point that we're now about to conduct. So I do it in a form of wording, which I'm going to first of all convey to you in the Irish language, and then subsequently will convey in English. Harkon. Kalashte igrifa, agus korla javu kalikte agus kalikte erin, bunum kalikte, fialamori an kalashte, avin kaidanamach, ilekna kalikte, agus irum gagurtu, ne fialamori fame of ride, han gafedalam a quid par a herbert doive gaformul. And let me now repeat that in English for the benefit of those who don't have Irish as their mother tongue. On behalf of Griffith College, and Quality and Qualifications Ireland, I hereby confer the awards on the learners of the college who have achieved the standards determined for those awards, and I ask that those learners be presented to me so they may formally present them with their parchments. Congratulations.
Irmanish Kate Rellis, Stiorahor Clore, Irhori Herbert. I call upon Kate Rellis, Programme Director, to present candidates in respect of the college's business programmes.
Good afternoon, graduates, friends, family, faculty members, and all who join us here today. On behalf of the Faculty of Business and Judy, it is a great honour as the Acting Programme Director to stand here in front of you all, addressing you on this very special day. Many of you from the Business and Accounting and Finance programmes may not know me and are probably wondering what words of inspiration or wisdom I can pass on to you as you enter into a world filled with hopes, dreams, and opportunities. Each and every one of you have accomplished a lot during particularly difficult circumstances over the last couple of years. You will have all taken away something different from your time here in Griffith College, Limerick, be it new friends, family, new ways of thinking or processing ideas, as well as decision-making skills, and let's not forget how to use Zoom. Take those skills and run with them. The world is now your oyster. Go and continue to be a source of inspiration to your family, friends, and colleagues. As Judy is unable to be here with us today, she asked me to pass on her congratulations to you all, and we both hope that your time here in Griffith College was a memorable experience. We hope you stay connected with us, and we look forward to seeing you excel in your chosen fields. Some of you who have participated on the hospitality programmes may be all too familiar with me. Eilish and I are thrilled and delighted to see how far you have come from those very eager, enthusiastic students who entered the doors of the Limerick campus a few short years ago. Graduates, I wish to congratulate you on your academic achievements, and I hope you are very proud of yourselves, as I know your friends and family are. As American Henry David Thoreau once said, go confidently in the direction of your dreams and live the life that you have imagined. President, I present to you the following candidates who have successfully completed programmes and who are worthy of their ICM and QQI awards. Diploma in International Hospitality Management, Bachelor of Arts in International Hospitality Management, Bachelor of Arts in Business Studies, Bachelor of Arts in Accounting and Finance, ICM Diploma in Marketing Management, and Certificate in Digital Sales Transformation. Diploma in International Hospitality Management, Ayanda Kunene. Luana Silva Fonseca. Bachelor of Arts in International Hospitality Management, Josimer Alberto Barbosa. Beniza Ali. Andrea Borges. Thank you. Eva Carrigan. Dylan Deegan. Lock Ye Ho. Fernanda Lima da Silva. Alan Leet Mikado Jr. Bachelor of Arts in Business Studies, HRM, Hannah Moran Clancy. Brian Gallagher. Padraig Murphy. Roxana Zabo. Bachelor of Arts in Business Studies, Cameron D. Benedetto. Larissa Felix. Thomas Gleason. Emer Horrigan. Jeanne Klein. Patrick Noonan. John O'Brien. Manuel Rodriguez dos Santos Neto. Dirk Swanpole. Leonardo Tademi Zucca. Bachelor of Arts in Accounting and Finance, Rachel Collins. Rafael Dos Reyes Arantes. Gráinne Fogarty. Helen Hartnett. Dean Hogan. Sabana Kakar. Fiona O'Brien. Emerson Gutierrez Santos. Barbara Versani. Certificate in Digital Sales Transformation, Shauna Boylan. Siobhan Doherty. Susan Higgins. Valerie Kelly. Fidelma Reed. Aima Sajjad.
Irminish Brendan Fogarty, Stiúrthóir Clár, Iarrthóirí Herbert. I call upon Brendan Fogarty, Programme Director, to present candidates in respect of the College's BTEC Higher National Certificate in Manufacturing Engineering.
Distinguished guests, President of Griffith College, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to sincerely congratulate the graduates of the Engineering Department of Griffith College, Limerick. I'll remember with fondness your enthusiasm, your quest for knowledge, and the informal chats I had with many of you here today. Your qualification will greatly assist you in the pursuit of further studies or inquiring employment in local industry, where Griffith College has created strong links with both computing and engineering companies such as Dell, AMCS and Johnson & Johnson, amongst others. So just some advice for our graduates here today. First piece of advice is to dream big. So a quote from one of my favourite movies is, make your lives extraordinary. So now that you have gained your qualification, what you can achieve in your professional lives has no limitation. Second piece of advice is to work hard. Find a career you enjoy, work hard, and set an example for others to follow. Third piece of advice is not to be afraid of failure. Carpe diem, or seize the day, is another quote from the film Dead Poets Society. So do not be afraid to take risks or to think outside the box. If you make mistakes, learn from them and move on. And lastly, be kind. My own experience, it is very important to be kind to others and the environment. Be kind to those around you. It will pay dividends in the long term. Don't ask someone to pay you back. Instead, consider asking them to pay it forward instead. Be kind to the environment. We all need to care for it and protect it for future generations. So, congratulations again. I, as program director, am immensely proud of your achievements and wish you every success in the future. We here in Griffith College Limerick look forward to hearing each of your success stories. President, I present to you the following candidates who have successfully completed their programs and who are worthy of their BTEC awards. So the candidates are for the Higher National Certificate in Manufacturing Engineering BTEC. So Zane Gomez de Almeida. Adrian Murphy. Ian St. John.
Irmanish Eamon Nolan, Irahoria Herbert. I call upon Eamon Nolan, Head of Academic Programs, to present candidates in respect of the college's Bachelor of Engineering in Industrial and Systems Engineering.
President, colleagues, graduates and guests, welcome to the section where we award parchments to the graduates of the Bachelor of Engineering and Industrial Systems Engineering programme. John McDonough, who is the programme director for this programme, unfortunately can't be here today. Recently, John was involved in an accident while cycling and sustained a number of injuries. I spoke with him yesterday, and he's in good form and on the path to recovery and hopes to be back in the saddle soon, both metaphorically and physically. He sends his best wishes to the graduates of 2022 and asks that I pass on his congratulations to you all on your achievements. I know John is watching online, and on behalf of you, the graduates, and everyone here, I want to send best wishes to John and wish him a swift recovery. My role in the college is Head of Academic Programmes, and I have worked closely with John over the past number of years in developing this programme to be one of the leading programmes in its field. To the graduates, I'm very happy to be able to talk to you today now that your course of study has been successfully completed and you are already playing an active part in the field of industrial engineering. You are now qualified engineers, ready to take the next step up in your career with skills and methods which allow you to increase your contribution to successful outcomes in your work. This was already demonstrated in your capstone projects. These included projects concerned with introduction and commissioning of new equipment in an electronic component manufacturing company, increasing the load-unload capability of steel processing machines, improving the productivity of the tool crib in an aircraft maintenance facility, automating the grinding process in a medical devices plant, and reducing setup time in a precision engineering plant. These are all examples of how you are giving your employers the benefits of what you have learned within months of starting your program. One of the reasons is because the techniques of industrial engineering are extremely practical and almost immediately can become part of the company's improvement plans. John has a lovely quote, which I've heard him use on many occasions over the years. He says, "Engineers make things. Industrial engineers make them better." Industrial engineers look to a different method of communication for solutions and effective compromise so that improvements can be made and agreement can be achieved. My own background is in computer science, but I've always said if I was to choose another discipline, it would be engineering. Every engineer I know is a problem solver. A good friend of mine, an engineer of course, always says, "There are no problems, only challenges to be overcome." I love that attitude, and it is nowhere better manifested than in the discipline of industrial and systems engineering. Industrial engineers play a key role in the management of complex systems of equipment, change leadership, quantifiable knowledge, and return on investment to provide competitive advantage and future growth. You are playing your part in this competitive effort through the application of these techniques and tools. They have stood the test of time and have been adopted by all the leading companies in the world. The industrial engineer adopts a role that is critical in developing and maintaining a competitive advantage, a role that is rightly prized in these uncertain times. Be very proud of your achievement in opening up the opportunity for a career in engineering and in management. I can tell you that it is no small accomplishment, and now you can look forward to working as a member of the Institute of Industrial and Systems Engineers, where we can continue watching your careers grow and develop. Well done. President, I now present to you the following candidates who have successfully completed the Bachelor of Engineering in Industrial and Systems Engineering and are worthy of their QQI awards, and I ask that you present their parchments to them. Francis Byrne. Richard Campbell. Nigel Crow. Jennifer Donovan. Laura Fabrisusa. Jamie Farrell. David Faulkner. Owen Flatley. Hervaye Kirin. Maciej Karolowski. Fergus McCarthy. Dara Maloney. John Moran. Pat Murphy. Gerard Phelan. Philip Poldrugaj. Tony Purcell. Padraig Roach. Martin Shaw. Sasa Slijepcevic.
Did you get that?
I thought I did all right. Paul Thornbury. Walid Zimiers Walny.
As we conclude our conferring of awards, I'd like to invite everyone to give a special round of applause to all our graduates here today. And remembering that many of their colleagues and classmates are graduating today online, we might reach out with a round of applause to them too. And there is a third group. So in the time-honoured tradition of Griffith College, we would ask the families, friends and relations to stay seated while the graduates stand up. We would now ask the graduates to turn to their families, friends and relations and give them a round of applause for all the support you received on the way. Thank you. Please be seated. Tá anas anois ag an gláiste dúiseanna bhronna ar a siúd a dairí lóbar fiáise winter mark in a good lane. The college now has the pleasure of announcing a number of prizes which are awarded to graduates who have achieved excellence in their studies. And the following prize is awarded in respect of the college's business programmes, and I call upon Kate Rellis, Programme Director, to present this prize. The prize is awarded in respect of the BA Honours in Business Studies. The best academic achievement on the Bachelor of Arts Honours in Business Studies is awarded to John O'Brien. The following prize is awarded in respect of the college's engineering programmes, and I call upon Eamon Nolan, Head of Academic Programmes, to present the prize. It's awarded in respect of the Bachelor of Engineering in Industrial and Systems Engineering. The best academic achievement on the Bachelor of Engineering in Industrial and Systems Engineering is awarded to Paul Thornbury. And the final prize is a college-wide prize awarded to the Griffith College Limerick Graduate of the Year. We have a number of ceremonies here today, and this prize is being awarded at this ceremony. It's awarded in respect of a graduate of the Bachelor of Arts in Accounting and Finance. I call upon Kevin O'Sullivan, Head of the Griffith College Limerick Campus, to present the prize. The 2022 Graduate of the Year is Rachel Collins. Corlor, Ian Urica, Aguina Ushla, Karim Clearclish and Sharman Ashok, Kondavoktani of Runa, Erkamehan Kalashta, Berenbuikas Liv Galer. Councillor, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the ceremony for the purpose of conferring awards on the graduates of the college. My best wishes and thanks to you all. While the graduates are here with us, I'd like to take this opportunity to briefly mention the Griffith College Alumni Network. With over 40,000 graduates living in Ireland, Europe, and in over 100 countries worldwide, the network is an excellent way to stay in touch with classmates, fellow graduates, and the college. The network is also proving to be a valuable resource for graduates seeking or changing employment. As we move towards the college's 50th anniversary, we're also delighted to see our graduates from earlier years using the network to appoint and select graduates from Griffith for their own organisation's needs. Details about the network are on Griffith Alumni Network and on the college's website. On behalf of the college, I would like to invite all of the guests of the graduates here today to enjoy a glass of wine, cup of tea or coffee, and refreshments immediately afterwards in this room. I would ask the graduates to oblige us for a few more moments while we capture on film just how lovely they look today as we take photographs of you down there. Once the photographs have been taken, the graduates can rejoin their guests and celebrate their achievements in style. For now, we wish you every joy and happiness in celebrating your success with your close friends throughout the day. And as a token, we've boxes of chocolates for everybody as you leave the room today. Please stand for the academic procession.